Okay, you know what time it is. We're at the Fight Factory. It's British Boxers time. And we're about to be introduced to Sean Krool's newest signing. Introduce yourself to the cameraman.
Yo, what's up, people? My name is Josemir Um-Laka Poulino. Sean just gave me that new nickname, so I'm very proud of it. And I'm here to take out hearts, you know. I'm hungry, and I want to rip out everybody's heart.
That's you want to rip out everyone's heart, yeah?
Everybody's heart.
That's sort of like what Mike Tyson used to say to Lennox Lewis and stuff like that, you want?
Yeah.
What's that nickname, man? Um-Laka.
Um-Laka, yeah.
Um-Laka. What does that mean?
It means Uncle Nice, but in South.
No, in Dutch.
Uncle Nice.
Um means uncle. Yeah. And Laka means nice.
Yeah, I know what Laka means because it's a Laka bot, can't you? Yeah, like, Laka yeah. friend. So, all right. Yeah. So you say you want to take out people's hearts. Yeah. What do you actually mean by that?
I mean that I want to. My goal is. I said it in Holland before. I'm from Curacao. It's a nice small island in the Caribbean. And when I was 12, I moved to Netherlands, Amsterdam. But I'm here to take over, man. Mm-hmm. I'm not here to just box or fight. I'm here to do that too, but to rip out hearts.
Yeah, man. All right. What weight are you going to be fighting at?
Money weight.
Money weight? Yep. What's that, welterweight?
No, that's if the money is right, the boy will take the fight.
Anyway.
I see, I like it.
No, Sean super
is
welter.
Sean is the boss and he's telling me that super welter.
Yeah. Well, super welter is a good money division because a lot of good fights out there are £154, isn't there? Yeah. All right, Sean, tell us a little bit about how this happened then, this teaming up.
So, working with Steven, and I've had one of Steven's old sponsors for Flame Fight Gear, and he used to work with Josemir before, and he Diamond La Cruz, and he then put me in touch with Josemir, and he put Josemir in touch with me, and then I spoke to Josemir's old manager, Sil, and we've got on, and then I've had a meeting with her on the phone, flew over to Holland, and then put everything together. So I'm a bit comfortable with the language.
Yeah.
Although, of course, Afrikaans is almost the same as Dutch, so I'm comfortable around in the surroundings because we basically almost talk the same language.
Yeah.
You know, it's Afrikaans, Dutch, and Flemish is very close to each other.
Yeah.
So I'm comfortable when I go over. So hopefully we'll be seeing more Dutch fighters.
All right, man. All right.
Because this will be the home of the Dutch fighters, and okay. Yeah, Josemir is, he's a. Let's call him a bright character.
Bright character.
Yeah, he's always, you can come in dull in the morning, he'll make things bright.
Okay, we like that. We like
sometimes
that.
Too bright, but always bright.
That's good, man. That's good. Tell us about your record. What's your record?
My record, or you mean my street record? Or my
tell us your street record, amateur record, and then your professional record.
My street record, I can't tell you that. Okay. Otherwise, Sean will kick me out.
Kick you back out, all right.
Yeah, I don't want that. My amateur record, I don't know. I won most of my fights before the fight ended. I lost one fight to Peter Mullenberger. He went to the Olympics last year. And my professional record, I got 10 fights, 8 win, 2 lost, and I think 5-6 knockout. But the thing is this, I have a saying, when the bell rings, it's YOLO. You know, so I don't really, I'm not really looking at my record or everybody else's record or whatever. No, I'm hungry and that's why I want to rip out hearts.
Yeah, man.
So when the bell sounds, it's going, you see me laugh, I don't laugh. Because I'm dead serious about this shit.
About this shit. All right, okay, good. Well, obviously, we love characters. Obviously, you moved all the way over and relocated to England, sunny Manchester. What do you make of Manchester?
Oh man, Manchester is to this time is great, man. I've been welcomed here with open hands, and I had some great sparring with Steven. He's up for his title, his belt.
Yeah.
And with another South African guy who had 17 fights or something like that, Bongini.
Okay.
Bongani, sorry about that. And yeah, man, it's great. It's great. The only thing is, you need money, right? Because when you fight, you get money and everything. But I love this, man. It's really in my heart, you know? Fighting, training, fight, boxing, training, it's really in my heart. That's why Sean is telling you that when you're here, I'm bright in Curacao, where I'm from, not Holland. I moved to Holland. I'm not from Holland. Mm. Holland is a great country. Also, it's England is a great country, but I'm not from Holland. Do I look from Holland? No. I don't look like something.
Look like you're from Curacao to me.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. But there we have a beer, and it's called Amstel Bright. So that's why I think you say I'm bright.
All right.
No, but in the morning, let's say it's 6 o'clock in the morning or 3 o'clock in the morning, I love doing it. I'm loving it. So when I hear the music and everything, I'm in my zone because I love this. When I was the first sparring with Steven, I was here, I had my music on. I told him, he was punching me everything and telling me, no, you're not good. But I love that, you know, I'm really in the zone. I think, yes. And I couldn't believe it. I was in the ring and I was like, oh damn, I'm really doing this, you know? And I love this.
Yeah, man.
I love this. I'm still working on my English accent, and eh? But stand there, don't you worry, and eh?
Yeah, I like it. Regional. All right, Sean, can you bring more characters over like this as well, please, in the future? All right, man. Any final comments from you guys? Go on, Sean.
My comment, final comment is, he's got to back it up now. It's good talking, but we want to see how many hearts he can lick or beat or pull out or rip out. But we want to see him back up with his predictions and his words. I know we'll make it colorful.
Yeah.
You know, we'll make the fight seem colorful. A lot of promoters will want him on their shows because I know he's a bit crazy sometimes. We have to pull him back and, you know, we have to tighten
him. Nah, you're not
we have
pull
to
him
tighten
back.
Him. No, we have to. We have to. We don't want him too much because some that will scare the promoters away.
Okay.
But he's a colorful character. So we have a lot of balance in our, you know, that's where we have the world map on our badge, you know, on our crest we have it, because we're from all over the world.
Yeah.
You know, and that's what we want to bring. We want to bring entertainment, we want to bring excitement, and we are a bunch of characters from, you know, we just want to bring something different to the Manchester boxing scene, to the British boxing scene.
All right, man. Final word to you then.
I'm here to learn from Sean and from the whole team. So, and when they say they have to pull me back sometimes, yeah, that's good, you know, because I'm really hungry for those hearts, you know, I'm really hungry.
Yeah.
And I'm going to try to back it up. Actually, I'm going to back it up, but let's say I'm going to try just to be nice and polite. My final words is I want to say hi to my mom. Hi, mom. And a big shout out to Cuddle Buck and Andy Spartacus. That's it.
Man, all right, a man that has such a wants to rip hearts out. Hello, mom.
I know, yeah. Yeah. You know. Well, listen, guys, you know what time it is. British boxers time. Power.